Good morning, Red Devils. This is Isaac Felix, your ASU president. Please stand and join me for the pledge. Put your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberties and justice for all. Thank you. You may now be seated.
Good morning, Red Devils.
I'm Abby.
And I'm Naomi.
And this is your Red Devils Review. Hey guys, this week we are pledging to be drug free. Why?
Because it's
Red Ribbon Week.
My name is Bethany Hamilton. I'm 22 years old and I'm from Kauai, Hawaii. I started surfing technically when I was in my mom's womb. So I mean, I've always just grew up at the beach, hanging out, surfing, and doing little fun contests, and yeah, I just loved it. At 13, I finished second in the under 18 nationals, which is like the biggest competition for under 18 amateur surfing, and so that was a huge result. From that point, I was like, kind of like, okay, this girl means business. Like, I was like heading towards the pro tour. Like, I was gonna be a pro surfer. And then that next fall is when I lost my arm, and it was like, whoa. It was a gorgeous day in Hawaii, and I went surfing with my best friend, Alana, and her dad and brother, and the water was just perfect, glassy, blue ocean. And the waves were kind of small, but just wanted to get wet and just hanging out there waiting for waves, and all of a sudden a shark came from nowhere. I didn't see anything and just took my arm and like that, and from that point I just focused on surviving, and you know, my friends were there by my side helping me get to the beach. Kind of crazy to see how that turn of event like has changed my life dramatically, but at the same time, I'm still a professional surfer today, living the dream I've always wanted to and accomplishing more than I ever dreamed of. A lot of the good surfers that I grew up surfing with and that were my age, some of them did choose to do drugs, and for me it wasn't really a hard decision not to, because I saw the negative effect it had on them. One particular girl who I really looked up to, she's an amazing surfer, and she chose to get into this drug scene and she lost it. I still see her every now and then, and my heart just breaks just knowing that she was so talented. She was that one that, like, I wanted to surf like her. And I saw her just lose that love and passion and natural ability. From what I've seen, it's like I see people start with weed and, you know, they almost become like a slave to it, and you see them kind of lose their drive in life. Like, they just kind of get stuck in a rut of like just smoking weed and just kind of living it day by day and spending all their money on that, wasting their money, wasting their life. And then they eventually get bored with weed and a lot of times end up dabbling with other drugs, and then it just goes downhill from there, and just so unappealing to me. Go through hard times in our life, and you know, it might not necessarily be losing your arm to a shark. Maybe it just struggles in school or family issues or whatever it is. Don't give up. Like, just find your passions and your joys and things that motivate you and inspire you to live a full life, and shoot for those and keep pushing forward towards the light at the end of the tunnel and rather than giving up. I'm Bethany Hamilton, and my natural highs are surfing, hanging with friends, family, my love for God, living a healthy lifestyle, and just smiling.
Ready to go? Come on, come on. College applications are this week, so make sure you get your grades on fleek, because going to college will get us the knowledge. Hey, seniors, your college application workshops are this week, so remember to attend to apply for college. Wait.
Teacher.
Nurse.
But when I went to buy the costume, I was like, where's the rest of it? I'd much rather be a
King Kong,
Loch Ness,
Goblin, Ghoul, a zombie with no conscience. But no matter what garments we wrap ourselves in,
a woman's status as trick, treat, or geek is not up for discussion.
If a woman wants to wear a skimpy outfit, let it be
her choice.
If a woman wants to cover up, let it be
her choice.
Class, if I can have your attention. So we are here, myself and some of our counselors are here to present a very special award. So every week we're presenting the Red Devil Way Award to a very special student that is nominated by either a fellow student or a staff member. So this student was nominated, and here's what the person wrote about the student. This person is always on task and models respectful behavior in class. She sets a good example for her fellow classmates and is an excellent example of the Red Devil Way. So, the characteristic this person exemplifies at school is respect. One of the characteristics of the Red Devil Way, respect. So let's give a big round of applause for Ms. Lynn Garcia. Yay!
Hey everyone, my name is Ricardo. I'm part of the after school program. I'm one of the advisors for CAC, College Awareness Club. You're welcome to join us. We meet Mondays in room 605 at 2:40. If you have any questions about college, career, financial aid, scholarships, how to write your essay, like stop by. Also, if you want me to review your application, feel free to stop by in the computer lab after school. I'm there Tuesdays. So yeah, thank you. Hope to see you there.
Hello everyone, we are members of Peer Club, Peers United to Restore the Environment, and we are here today to talk to you about an upcoming competition we are hosting.
Our third period class recycling competition will start soon, so we encourage everybody to come and recycle all that you can and help save the planet as well.
In your third period class, starting November 3rd, every teacher will have a black bag such as this one, where you students can put old notebooks, newspapers, or papers that you no longer use, and at the end of the week, we will come by and pick them up and determine a winner. The class that recycles the most will win a prize. Good luck to you all, and we hope to see everyone participating. Have fun, and bye!
Time for Suhai Sports! Woohoo! Well, today, our Frosh Suhai football team will be playing at Mar Vista at 3 p.m.
And tomorrow will be our last home game for the varsity football players at 7 p.m. versus Mar Vista. So make sure to go and support.
And fill up all damn bleachers. Well, see you tomorrow and today.
For any of you who are interested in playing basketball for Sweetwater,
because ball is life, there is a general meeting in the new gym at lunch tomorrow. So, see you then.
This is Tony, the coach for tennis, and this is...
I'm Nikki Ray, I'm the co-captain of the tennis team.
Successful. I mean, one word to sum it up is successful. We ended up the season with 12-0 record, which stated us undefeated. All of our hard work and dedication really paid off this season. Last year we went co-champs, but we didn't really reflect off of last year. We were able to overcome our objections and our fears and did great.
Students, I am so looking forward to Halloween. I'm gonna dress up. I know you're gonna dress up, but I need to tell you, you can't wear anything that is offensive to other people. It's against school rules, or plain and simple, just shows too much. Please remember that even though you're dressing up, that you do have to follow school procedures. Also, you cannot cover up your face. You can decorate your face, you can wear makeup, and you have fun. But do not cover up your face, because we've got to make sure it's you that's in the classroom. So don't forget, if you think it offends anyone, if you're not sure, it probably does and you shouldn't. So, give you some examples. Think of Pokemon instead of Playboy. Think of rated G instead of rated R. Do the right thing. Let's have fun, dress up, and enjoy it. And don't forget, we do have a game that night. And for that game, you can dress up too. So we'll see you at the game. Thank you.
Halloween is tomorrow, so it's going to be candy and calories and pumpkins, friends, costumes, and more candy and fun, lots of fun. But remember, students, dress appropriately, have a great time out there. And anyways, we will be having a little event where we will have the best costume. We're going to have most creative, most original, and most of all, most scariest, and best squad. So you know what, just go out there and have some fun.
Thursday, October 30th from 3 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. is going to be the Ballet Folklorico Tapatlán Kermes. It's gonna be between the old gym and the ASB. You guys should all go. It's gonna be a lot of fun. There's gonna be food, entertainment, and so much fun.
Buenos días, los invitamos el día jueves 30 de octubre a la Kermes organizada por el Ballet Folklorico Tapatlán.
De 3 a 5 y media p.m. entre el old gym y el ASB. Habrá comida, entretenimiento, juegos, actividades.
When we come to the end of the show, no, I can't let go.
Well, we did come to the end of the show.
And we have to let go.
Yeah.
So you know what?
I'm Ellie.
And I'm Abby.
And this has been
your Red Devils Review. Make it a great day.
Or not, the choice is yours.
Ah, you're joking. You're joking. I can't believe my ears. Would someone shut this fella up? I'm drowning in my tears. It's funny, I'm laughing. You really are too much. And now, with your permission, I'm going to do my stuff.
Well, what are you going to do?
I'm going to do the best I can.